Hi, this is Marcus. We're going to do a quick edit in black and white here on this photo here. Now, I did all my color grading inside Capture 120, and Capture One does very good black and whites as well. If I wanted to do this as a black and white, basically inside of Capture One, I would right click and I would just create a variant, right? So we would want to make this into a clone variant. I could go ahead and just, you know, do my black and whites and do the things I want to be able to do with that. But what I want to show you today is I want to be able to do it with the plugin. And the plugin we're going to use is we're going to right click and we're going to open this up with Civil Effects. Now, Civil Effects will work as a standalone application, and because it's a standalone application, it will work inside of Capture One. It also has a plugin feature that works within Photoshop and within Affinity Photo. But we're going to do this out of Capture One. So let's click this here. And then it's going to ask me what do I want to use as far as the variant of exporting this. We're going to export this as a TIFF, as a 16-bit, but I don't want Adobe RGB. We're going to do it as sRGB. And we're going to go ahead and click Variant. And this is going to open up Civil Effects, and I'm going to go ahead and do a very quick edit inside of this photo or plugin application. Now, this has come in with the basic settings of the black and white. You can see the metadata information down here about the file. These are some presets that I've created, but we're not going to use any of those presets. We're going to just start from scratch. So let's just go ahead. These are some presets that come within the application itself. Again, we're going to do all this from scratch. So we're going to go ahead and go into the global settings of this. Now, overall, this looks pretty good. But what I'm going to do right now is we're going to control the brightness. So if I go ahead and say I want to give this some brightness, now I've brightened this up, but I can go into different areas of the photo and say, let's darken the highlights within that brightness. If I want to darken the shadows, I can pull the shadows down within that brightness. This gives you a lot of control, and I can pull down the midtones, right? So let's pull the midtones down. Even though we got brightness in here, we're introducing brightness. We're controlling different parameters within that brightness. Now, this is dynamic brightness. If I do this, of course, you'll see that it'll just make it harsh and kind of darken it. I can go into here and actually lighten it up as well. So we're just going to keep it the way we got it here. And we have contrast, the same thing with contrast. Now, contrast basically amplifies the whites and the blacks is what it does. If I pull this, you'll see the white will get whiter and the darker would get darker. But I can do this and go back and say, if I want to amplify the whites, I could just amplify the whites. If I wanted to amplify the darks, I could do that. So 30 would be just too much. I can take it the opposite way as well. That's the way that I would actually do it. Take it the opposite way, right? And then if I want to amplify the blacks, I can pull that up and I can amplify it. And then if I want to amplify the whites, I can do that as well. You see that? Just by doing it, just by pulling this up like this, we amplify the whites. We're going to put it here. We're going to put this like this here. And now structure is going to make things a little bit sharper. If I go and pop that down again, I could say give me some structure in here. But again, I could say, you know what? I want to protect the structure. Let's go minus in the shadows. We don't want that to be. But I do want the midtones to be a little bit more structured. And I want the highlights. So now, if we look at this and we zoom into this right here and move this up, you can see the photo is looking pretty good. It's pretty sharp. Everything looks very good on this photo. We can take this back down. And then we can protect the shadows within here. I can go in here and say, you know what? I want to protect my shadows. Let's protect that. You see what it does with the shadows when it's protecting the shadows? Or if I want to protect the highlights, I can do that as well. So let's give a little bit of protection for those things there. These are my global adjustments. And because they're my global adjustments, I can actually, you know, this is the overall of how I can actually set everything up. So now when I minimize this and I go into selective, what this will allow me to do is drop a control point. And on that control point, so let's say we're going to drop one on this coat here, right? And I want to see what is actually highlighting. So it's going to show me what it's actually affecting. We want to pull this down to here. And we want to reduce this to where it's just affect the coat. Okay. So now we go into here. and we take that off. Now, I have my individual things that I can do with this. If I want to add more structure to this, you know, that's a selective color. This is fine structure, and this is structure. If I want to add more structure to that, I could just pull that in right there, right? And that's going to add a little bit more. And if I hold my Alt key and click on this, I can drag this, and now I can make a copy of it, right? I can pull it down like this, and then when I made a copy of that one, I can just pull this down. So I'm just selecting that area. I don't want to select too much of what I don't want to select, right? So we're going to drag this right here, and we can put it on there. I can put it here. I can put a little bit of it here on her hair. I can pull it down, right? And I'm going to pull a little bit over here, right? But then we're going to reduce that amount down like this. So we're just hitting that hair. So now again, if we go in 100% of this, you can see that the coat is really defined. You can really see everything in there. You can see parts of the hair as well that we want you to see. I'm going to hold my Alt key down and copy this over like this as well. Put it over here, right? And that actually works pretty good. And so then when I do that, let's take this back out. We're going to zoom out. I can go ahead and grab all these control points and highlight them and group them. If I move anything, it's going to affect all of them. So if I pull this down and make it darker, you'll see that gets darker. If I wanted to make it lighter, this will get lighter. So let's make it a little bit lighter right there. And that actually looks pretty good there. And then we're going to go ahead and go to the other part. Now, just because you have all of these parameters doesn't mean you have to use them. So if I click on green, that's going to show me. And if I click on yellow, of course, that's going to give me a yellow filter. And I like that yellow filter about what it's doing. I can increase the strength of it. I can bring the strength a lot. We're going to take the strength back down to what it was before. About maybe 32. That's what I like on there. And we got that nudged in the bag. And now we got femme type. Now with this femme type, they have some femmes in here. And the new version has just added some new stuff. You can see these new things that they just added. Now when you click on these, what this does is it's going to change the curve and the sensitivity sliders and the grain sliders. That's what this is going to affect. It's not going to affect my filter. It's not going to affect what I've selected as an adjustment. And it's not going to affect my global. It's just going to affect what's in here, trying to mimic a femme look. So let's go in here and take a look at what they got here. If I see anything that I think that I want to add to this that's new, we can go ahead and just add that on there. I'm looking at what they have for newness in here. That's a new one for the Polaroid. I like this one here, but let's see what they got as far as that one. Well, let's do this one right here. We're going to do that one, and you can see what it's affecting, right? It gives me the grain, and if we go into this 100%, you can see that it gives you the grain of that femme, right? So we can really look at that and see the grain of the femme, and it looks very good. And that's what I really like about this program. This program is awesome. Now, I can still go in here and fine-tune this. If it was something that I didn't like, I can still fine-tune it. They got some highlights in here. I may want to pull some of this down. You see how that's affecting that? So I can pull some of this down and still affect a little bit of it and not affect too much of it. So they got these different sensitivity sliders. We're going to keep that there. I like that. Finishing this up, we have different what we call tonalities that we can use in here. If I go in here and decide I want to use a neutral tonality or if I want to go into something else, you can see what it does. Selenium kind of gives you that bluer tone. So if I wanted to use more like a coffee, right, or use this one, let's go with the coffee look, right? And it's got its settings. And we're going to go in here. If I push that up, you'll see where the balance of that is going. We can pull it down like this. Let's keep it around here. And we got the strength of this. We're going to pull that strength down a little bit more, right? And keep it about right there at 13. And of course, we got the paper and everything that we want to be able to, the paper toning. We can pull that up as well to tone it for the paper. That looks pretty good. And then we have our vignetting. If you want to put some vignetting on this, have a fall off. The fall off looks good. If I take it off, it's very bright. Let's have some fall off. We'll click this here. If you want to burn the edges, you can do that as well. We don't want to burn any edges. We want to keep it just like it is. So again, just because something's there don't mean you have to use it. And this photo is pretty much done. Now, if I want to make this into a custom look, I click this here. Let's go ahead and click in here, and I'm going to call this Fashion Cool Style. And that's the look for that, so I can save that preset, and that goes back to here. Right now, what a preset does is it saves everything except for your selective adjustments. It does not save the selective adjustments. It saves everything else, but not the selective adjustments, because of course those are the things that you put with control points on there. So it'll save everything but that. But this is done. So basically all I gotta do is hit save. And it writes it back into Capture One. I go from this photo. This is the raw file we sent over. And this is the file we brought back with us. That's the file, and it looks pretty good. The black and white looks very good. And so I just wanted to share that information with you, that you can use a lot of plugins within Capture One, especially if they're standalone applications as well. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to my station, and I'm going to bring you more of these type of tutorials. Thanks for watching.